Hello students, it's day 4 for chapter sound. Topic for today is sound. In previous lecture we have discussed about how sound requires a medium to propagate and speed of sound. The specific objectives of today's topic are reflection and absorption of sound and application of reflection of sound. So open page number 60 of your physics textbooks. Okay students, when you hit the ball on the wall, you can see that the ball bounces back from the wall. Now what happens when we speak? Does the sound also gets reflected by the wall? The answer is yes. And today we are going to discuss reflection of sound. Thus, reflection of sound is defined as the bouncing back of sound waves after striking a reflecting surface. A reflecting surface is generally flat, rigid or hard surface. Now why reflecting surface is flat, rigid or hard surface? Because sound wave cannot penetrate very far into this kind of surface. Now our next topic is laws of reflection of sound waves. Sound waves like light waves also obey the laws of reflection. The first law says the incident ray, reflected ray and normal lie on a same plane. And the second law says the angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. Now see this diagram students. Let AB be an incident ray or incident sound wave which strikes the hard surface, this hard surface, and then it reflects back as a sound wave BC. Now then BC will act as a reflected ray. Then angle I represents angle of incidence and angle R represents angle of reflection, where angle I is equals to angle R according to law of reflection. Now our next topic is verification of laws of reflection of sound waves. For this we'll perform an activity. Take two hollow cylindrical shaped objects which are open at both the ends. These are two hollow shaped cylindrical objects. Place them on the table like this, which is placed near the wall. Also make sure that table is covered with a white cardboard paper before keeping these pipes on it. Now place a running clock at the open end of the pipe facing you. Now keep your ear near to the open end of the other pipe. You will hear the ticking sound of the clock from the pipe. Adjust this pipe until the sound is more clearer. At one point it will be very clear. Now this is an example of reflection of sound. You are hearing the reflected sound here. The sound waves from the pipe, this pipe, through first pipe, which acts as an incident ray, gets reflected and passes through the other pipe and enters into your ear. You will notice that these angles, the angles, angle of incident as it is acting as an incident ray and angle of reflection as it is acting as a reflecting ray. So these two angles are approximately equal according to law of reflection of light. Now our next topic is absorption of sound waves. When a sound wave hits a soft or a porous substance, it gets absorbed. The kinetic energy of sound wave converts into a small amount of heat energy, causing it to die faster. Die faster, that is, sound wave is absorbed. Factors on which the amount of absorption depends. There are two factors on which the absorption depends. The first one is frequency of sound. A high frequency sound wave is absorbed more than a low frequency sound wave. That means if number of vibrations in 1 second is more, then it will be absorbed more. The sound will be absorbed more. Absorptive capabilities of the material. The absorption of sound wave also depends upon how porous the substance is. Next topic is applications of reflection of sound. The first application is speaking tube. In old movies, you must have seen this device. This is speaking tube. When we want a given sound to travel long distance before it gets inaudible, we can use speaking tube. As it confines or restricts the sound waves and avoids the wastage of sound energy by its transmission in all directions. This is a picture of air trumpet. It was used in ancient times. It is a machine used by a person with low hearing capabilities. It also confines the sound waves, due to which reflection of sound waves occur and thereby increasing the intensity of sound in air. Sound boards. This device is also used to increase the intensity of sound waves. Now, last application of reflection of sound waves is on page number 61. It says that when we curve our hands behind ears, we can hear distant sound clearly. Distance means far away sound. These curved hands act as a reflectors and they reflect the sound waves with a greater intensity to our ears. So we can listen to the sound more clearly. So learning outcomes of today's topic are the reflection of sound, laws of reflection, verification of laws of reflection of sound waves, absorption of sound waves, factors on which the amount of absorption depends, and applications of reflection of sound.